discuss about the second type of economic system, that is the centrally planned economy system. Well, a centrally planned economy is the exact opposite of a market economy. That is, in a centrally planned economy, all the decisions related to the economic activities are undertaken by the central or the state government with the main objective of social welfare. In fact, in such an economy, the role of private entrepreneurs is kept minimal. For example, North Korea and Cuba are two popular countries who operate as a planned economy. Now, let's analyze some important features of a centrally planned economy system. Well, first, the production process under a centrally planned economy is undertaken or governed by the government. Second, the factors of production are owned by the government in a planned economy. Third, the main focus of a centrally planned economy is on the social welfare. Fourth, the role of private entrepreneurs in such an economy is kept minimal. Fifth, the state not only manages the production activities, but also governs and controls the distribution of goods and services among the various sections of the society. And lastly, the three central problems of what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce are solved by economic planning, that is, the planning mechanism. Now, let me elaborate this feature a little more. Well, in a centrally planned economy, the three central problems are solved by designing suitable economic plans that are based on the needs and requirements of the society as a whole. Now, let's understand how these three central problems are solved in a centrally planned economy. Well, starting with the first, the problem of what to produce is solved by producing those goods and services which enhance the welfare of the society. For example, food grains and infrastructure are given more importance as they help in developing the society as a whole. The second problem of how to produce is solved by employing those techniques of production which best suits the economic conditions of the society. For example, if labor is in abundance than the capital, then more labor-intensive techniques would be used and vice versa. And lastly, the problem of for whom to produce is solved by producing for the society as a whole. For example, those goods and services will be produced which help in eliminating the social problems such as poverty, unemployment, inequality, etc. Now, this was all about the centrally planned economy. In the next video, we'll discuss more about the third type of economic system, that is the mixed economy system. Until then, stay tuned.